Hi, this is Steve Matley. Today I'm with Kerry Bowman. He is the pastor of the Awakening Church in the Temecula Valley area. What makes somebody a Christian and what does that mean?
I like to use the word Christ follower because it's truly being a Christ follower that we see change and transformation happen in our life, I believe. It doesn't solve all of our problems, doesn't make life nice, smooth, and easy, but it brings the hope and the joy and the purpose that's there. I think as we do life on the mission field, again, the Awakening Church, fully alive in Christ and to His mission, what's in the heart of people is a longing, in particular in four ways. And I think the message of the Christian faith has to address these four. That is origin, meaning, morality, and destiny. Where did I come from? How do I find meaning in life? How do I distinguish between good and bad? And what's my eternal destiny? And the Christian faith, the Christian message, has to address all four of those. And the gospel of Jesus Christ does address all four of those in a comprehensiveness of truth and a coherency of life. And so my interest is conveying in message, as well as with my personal life, the hope that is found in the gospel of Jesus Christ. And so when you become a Christian, when you become a true Christ follower, you're receiving the forgiveness of God through what He did with His death on the cross and His resurrection from the grave. You're receiving that covering for your sins, and you're made perfect in His sight because He now comes to live within you. And you begin following His reign and His leadership and His rule. And so that's sort of where I get jazzed, because the gospel, the good news, the hope of the kingdom isn't just about, hey, you can become a nice guy. It's about you can find transformation and enter into this eternal community, both now and forevermore, of being with the One who truly created all things. And so that's tremendously energizing to me. It's what gets me up out of bed every morning and say, I got the gospel of hope. And the church, local churches, we get to steward the life-changing message of the gospel of Jesus Christ. And it's good news. But the bad news is there is brokenness, evil, fallenness in the world, but it comes back to the brokenness in people's lives. That's why there's brokenness in our world. So there is bad news. But the good news comes to invade the bad news, that transformation can happen. And that transformation is found in a personal relationship with Jesus.
How do I follow a man who has been dead for 2,000 years?
The resurrection is unique into the Christian faith. And so Jesus came alive after 3 days of being in the grave. He's fulfilled the prophecies that were told of Him, even as He spoke of Himself. He appeared to hundreds of people for another period of a month or so, and then He physically ascended into the heavens. And when He ascended into the heavens, it's the first part of Acts. But there is a time coming when Jesus Christ will come again, as surely as people live before Jesus came the first time. We live before He comes the second time, and we will know then, indeed, that He is truly alive. During these 2,000 years of the church age, we are not left alone. Jesus says, I will not leave you as orphans. I will come to you. And that day you'll know that I'm in my Father, and you in me, and I in you. And so He has these mystical words talking about His original plan was that He would physically ascend to heaven, but then His Spirit would come back and be able to walk amidst people, be able to penetrate the very lives of people so that He would be present with us. And so when I get up every morning and I'm jazzed, I'm not like, okay, I got to follow this dead man's creed again. I say, good morning, Jesus. What's your plan today? Let me know what to do. And I think that's one of the key things just to understand about the Christian faith is that we do not serve a historical figure, believe in a myth or a legend. We serve someone who is fully alive and present in our life, if we will but seek Him. There are no set of works that we can ever bring to God for Him to accept us. He is the one who did the great work for us. So we come just as we are. And Jesus, He said, repent and believe in me, for the kingdom is at hand. And what He meant by that was turn from your way of thinking and your indifference. Turn towards belief in me and let my kingdom, my rulership, my leadership come into your life. But my eternal, my full life begins today, and it can begin in any moment for anybody who would choose to repent, believe in Christ, receive the gospel of the kingdom, the leadership of Christ, and move forward just as you are. We had a guy speak at our church last week who was a convicted felon. And he came to receive Christ in the prison after some influence, and it was in the quietness of his cell on a broken cement floor where he just cried out and said, God, I need you. I want you to take my life. So you don't need the priest. You don't need the pastor. What you do need is the presence of Jesus speaking to you and you surrendering to him. When you come to know Christ, you begin seeking what he wants to write as his will in your heart. We've been given the scriptures that are very clear in several things, all right? But more important than that, I believe, is that you begin with seeking what God's telling you to do in your heart, and he will lead you to the obedience of the scriptures that's laid out. And some of those changes may come, but they won't be changes because I have to. They'll be changes because I want to. The Christian faith is a journey. It's a growing process. So coming to Christ, living for Christ, it's all measured in the same manner according to God. It's covered by his grace and what he's done for us and not what we do for him. Yeah.